It's Candy Shop 511. This is going to be a video hair how-to. Basically, I'm just going to show you how to do this style. It's very quick and extremely easy. I'm going to definitely start making an effort to show you guys all the different styles you can do with such a simple do, you know, twist. But I'm going to give you the 360 of it. You just saw some pictures. And like I said, it's very easy to do, so I'm going to go ahead and hop right to it. Okay, so things that you'll need for this hair tutorial, or hair style, it's going to be bobby pins, as always. These are my best friend, and I get the ones with the rounded ends so that it doesn't tear at my scalp, rip my hair out. You can also use the smaller ones, but since my kinky twists are rather long, I prefer the bigger ones for more stability. Optional items are headbands and a hair tie, and I'll show you what you might need those for. I like them to accent my outfits, but it's not a requirement. So I'm going to use a bright orange one so that you guys can see the contrast of how it accessorizes the hairdo, okay? All right, so for starters, I make a simple bang. Like I always say, your parts don't have to be straight. I just like mine straight. Real stickler parts, so... there we go. What I'm going to do is take one of those hair ties, preferably a smaller one, and just hold your hair down, tie your hair down in the front. Or you can just braid it. It's long enough to braid. The thing about I like about this hairstyle is that you can do it with short twists, long twists, medium twists, you can do it with skinny twists, fat twists, medium, it really doesn't matter. Like, it's pretty good hairstyle all around, no matter how long or thick your twists are. Okay, and so what I'm gonna do this time is take my headband. I'm gonna go ahead and put it behind the bang, just like that. Those of you that are wondering, I've had my twist in about 2 or 3 months now. It's getting about that time, so guess what I'm gonna do? My signature style, my kinky twist out, and I'll show you guys pictures of that. But right now, it's just crinkled because I braided them in plaits, about 5 plaits, and then I dipped them in hot water to crinkle them. Just as a different look from the normal spiral curl. But anyway, back to the hairdo. And what you're gonna wanna do, see if I can raise that up a bit. There you go. You're going to want to start at the tip, and then you're going to want to start rolling. And this will get easier with time, and it doesn't have to be perfect, but you do want it to be kind of even. And this is like a mini pompadour of sorts. And then you're just going to want to pin that into place. One on each side is what I usually do, and sometimes one right in the middle. You guys can see that. Okay. That, we're going to move on to our next section. And you're just going to go from your ears up. Parts don't have to be perfect, like I said. And we're just going to repeat this rolling method all the way back. Don't want to have too much hair, unless it's gonna, or it's going to be difficult to roll. And you don't want too little hair, because then it's going to be very thin and it's not going to give you that bump. What you're wanting it to do is for your bumps to increase as they go back. You know what I mean? This is a smaller one. You're going to want this to be a medium-sized bump. So, let's see if I can show you close up how I roll it. Start at my ends. Fold those. I twist them. I fold them under a little bit, and then I use my thumb almost like a curling iron, and then I use my other hand to secure it as I'm using my thumb to insert it and roll down. And you're going to have these bump out, and it's fine. You just grab them and kind of tuck them in and roll them. You'll get the hang, like I said. You'll get the hang of it. And it really doesn't have to be perfect. No hairstyle is. Just get it to where you feel comfortable. And just twist those under so that you don't have flyaways on the side. Take more bobby pins. And you're going to need more for this section because it's a thicker, wider section. It's a lot bigger than the front. So I do like before, secure my sides first. And then you're going to go for the middle and just make sure you secure the middle. And you're not going to want to go into the top of your bump because then it'll be dented like that and unshapely. So you want to keep its shape, but just secure in the back of the roll, if that makes sense. Let's see if I can show you guys. I just take it and I go right in the back and then push it forward. Okay, so we have that bump done. And then we're going to go for a third bump. Now you have the option of either making this bump even bigger, or you can taper it down a bit so it's kind of like fattest one in the middle and medium size on either side. I like to do it a little bigger, personally, but it's whatever you like, whatever you want. Let me just secure those. And here's the part where you can get creative. You can leave it down and just let it hang like so. I think that's really pretty. Or you can take it, put it in a ponytail, and this is where your other ponytail holder will come in handy. And you can just tie a ponytail to the side. I think this is kind of cute too. Just like that. Okay, and there's always the option of say you're a person that doesn't like hair on your neck, you can make that another bump. You can take it, back, roll it, and then just pin it like you did all the others. And making it a total updo. There's nothing wrong with that, right? With it being summer and all, yeah, it's hot. Who wants hair on their neck? You know? So sometimes I'll go to work with it pinned up halfway and half hanging down. Throughout the day, I'll get hot. So I'll pin up the bottom and just do a complete updo. Just like that. And like I said before, the headband is optional. You see if I can cover it up with a black one so that you guys can see, kind of get a feel of what it looks like without it. There you go. You know, you can do lots of different things. You can accent it with a flower. You can tie a headband around and let it hang in the back. A colorful one. Take flower, stick that in the side, give it a little pizzazz. What you think? You know, take it, make it yours, enjoy it. You know, it's just a basic style, and you guys can switch it up however you like. And that does it for this hair tutorial. And once again, as always, thank you to all my subscribers. You guys are awesome. Like I said, every time I log on, I have so many more. And if I can't thank you personally, I just want to thank you now. You guys are great. And I never thought I'd have this many people looking at me. Somebody's watching me. You know, I'm caring about what I'm talking about. So thank you so very much. And I hope you guys all have a good day. I just got off work, so I'm going to go ahead and get to some housework right now. So take it easy. All right. See you guys next time.